Hello everyone, welcome to my QuickBooks tutorial. This is our lesson 2 of QuickBooks. Now today we are going to go through a past paper. This one is a computer application 2, a practical for certificate students. Now remember, the practical paper normally has 3 questions. We have a question on AutoCAD, a question on publisher, and question on accounting package, and that is QuickBooks. So let us go through this question, task 3. Now we are told that Itanga Sacco Mart Limited, PO Box 9865000504 Webuye, deals in buying and selling of bicycles and bicycles component. Record the following financial details and transactions of the company using an accounting program. Let me just open the fresh. Open with Fox Reader. Okay. So remember, there are so many accounting programs, but for my case I'm going to use QuickBooks. So let me launch my QuickBooks. I'm using QuickBooks 2010. So let us create a new company. Code file, new company. Now I'm going to skip the interview. Then you give the name of the company. So it is called Itanga Sacco Mart. So Itanga. Okay. Limited. Then you're supposed to give the address, that is PO Box 9865. PO Box 9865. Then you have the postal address 00504. City is Webuye. You have Kenya. And you can go to next. So it is a limited company. I'll select company, limited liability or unlimited. Then you go to next. Now my financial year starts at November. So select November. I go to next. Then you're supposed to select a similar industry. Let me check anything that deals with motorcycle or, sorry, not motorcycle but bicycles. If the company does not fall under any of these industries, then you are advisable that you select this one, other or none. Whatever I select this one, let me see the accounts that will come with it. Let me just select this one, other, and I go to next. Then you finish. I'm going to save it there on a desktop folder called June exam. Save. Then you have to wait for some time as your company file is being created. Okay, so we are done. Okay. Now, in my first tutorial, I had actually explained the interface of the QuickBooks and QuickBooks basics, like how do you add a customer, how do you add a supplier, how do you add employees, and also how do you add accounts including items and services. So if you've not gone through that the first tutorial, I would advise you that you go through the first tutorial before you actually watch this second video, because this one is purely a past paper. You're going through past paper. So let us go to the next step. These are the balances as at 1st November 2016. Okay, so we have the delivery fund cost. So this one, you go to the charts of account. Go to the charts of account. Then you say new account. It is a fixed asset. It's called delivery fund. Now when you look at this one, the delivery fund, then we have the cost. So it means that delivery fund is the main account. It has a sub account of a cost. So first of all, we create the main account, but we don't enter any opening balance. So I just save and new. Then you give now the cost. Cost, you say the sub account of delivery fund. So cost is a sub account of delivery fund. Then you need to enter to opening balance. Opening balance is 1,350,000. It is 1,350,000. Is that? So I know this is at 1st November 2016. Let me just change this one. 2016. 1101. You see, okay. Save and close now. So we are done with that one. Now the next one, these are debtors. So a debtor is actually an account payable. So debtors are accounts payable. So meaning that these are customers. Sukuma Mwenda Sakos are customers. Wembe Sakos is also another customer. So you need to go to customer, then you enter these customers. So automatically when you enter a customer, an associated account that is through opening balance will be recorded. That is now account payable. So debtors are account payables, creditors are, debtors are account receivables, not payable. They are account receivables, creditors are accounts payable. So for debtors, we go to customers, then we record these customers. Automatically, accounts receivable accounts will be created. Okay, so this one is Kumamwendo circles. You go to customers. Let me just close this. Then you say new customer. You give the name Sukuma Mwendo. Just close this one. Sukuma Mwendo circles. So we need to give the opening balance of that is 253,000. 253,000. Now remember, the date is on 2016. That is 01. November. Then you say okay. Now let us analyze. Now when you look at this this an invoice, it means that this customer owes our company this amount, 253,000, because it's an invoice. Remember, an invoice is normally issued to a customer when the customer is going to pay for the goods later on or for the services later on. So this an invoice of it's an invoice worth 253,000. Okay, you can go to the next one. When the circle's mat, so a new customer, you call it Wembe circles mat. Let me see the opening balance for that. 750,200. You also need to change the date. 01. This is November. Let me say okay. So we are done with the customers. Now we go to suppliers. So for creditors, we go to suppliers, then we record this. So we have Weiwei, circle manufacturers, suppliers, new supplier. This one is Weiwei. This Weiwei circle manufacturers. Manufacturers. Let me see the opening balance for that. This 1,250,000. Is November. Say okay. Now the next one is Raichu circles tires. New supplier Raichu Soko tires. The opening balance for that supply is 420,120. You need to change the date. That is 11/01/2016. See, okay. We don't have to fill the other details because we've not been given. Now next is fixtures and fittings. This is an asset, so we go to charts of account, and remember it also has cost. So cost is sub account of fixtures and fittings. So go to charts of account, say new account, fixed asset, fixtures and fittings. So this is main account. So save and new, you give costs, and then you say the sub account of fixtures and fittings. You end up now the opening balance, and that is 343,200 as at 2016 first November. Say okay, save and close. So we are done with that. Now the next one is bank. So bank will be just under bank. Bank in brackets RR bank. Charts of account again. New. This one is bank. Continue. You say bank in brackets RR bank. Now you need to give the opening balance for that bank account and that is 226,300. That is first November 2016. Say okay, save and close. Now we have the next one. That is cash. Cash is also under bank. New account bank. That is cash. You need to give the opening balance for cash 148,410. 148,410. 2016. Say okay, save and close. Now, so we are done with entering balances. So you still have stock, you still have stock. So for stock, you go to items and services, then you say new item. Now when you look at this one, we don't have stock, so we need to go and edit. You go to edit preferences, items and stock, then you go to company preferences, check this, say okay. Now if I go back to items and services, say new, you can have stock there. So again, I refer you to my first video tutorial. You look at how we enter stocks. So I'll enter here the name, the cost, the selling price, then the quantity here, that is on hand. Then I select income account, which is normally sales. So the first item is mountain bikes. Mountain bikes, I say here mountain bikes. Mountain bikes, then I give the cost, that is 22,000. Selling price is 30,000. So you give here 22,000. Here you give 30,000. Okay. The quantity, they are 40. 40. Okay. So the total value, it will multiply 40 multiplied by 22,000. Don't forget to indicate the correct date. That is 1st November 2016. Then you select sales account. Do you have any sales account? Add new income account, we call it sales. Save and close. Okay. Now go to next stock part. Now the next one is ordinary bicycles. Ordinary bikes, not bicycles. Bicycles. Now the cost is 12,600. And I'm going to sell it at 18,000. Now the quantity is 184. So yeah, you need to indicate 184. Let me just go next. Sorry, you have not selected the sales account. Sales. I go to, okay, stock part. The next one is ordinary bicycle tires. Ordinary bicycles tires. Now the cost of that is 180. I'm going to sell that to 40. So 180. You say yeah, 240. I think the quantity is 343. And then you select sales. Let me just say next because I still have another one to enter. That is mountain bikes tires. Mountain bicycle tires. Bikes tires. So the cost of that one is 360. So I'll let that 500. 360. 500. There are 250. I'm not wrong. Select sales. Now, very important, you indicate the date. Sorry. 10/16. Okay. I think for the previous one, we could not indicate the correct date. That is ordinary bicycles. Ordinary bicycles tires. Let me just maximize this. This one. Let me just... I don't know if you can edit the date. Okay, we cannot edit that. But you need to indicate the correct date. Okay, so let me proceed to the next. So the next one, we can go to transactions. So the following transaction took place during the month of November. Now we have credit sales. Now when we talk of credit sales, it means that the company is going to sell on credit. So what we do, we issue the invoice because the customers are going to pay later on. We are selling on credit. Okay, so the customers are going to pay later, so you issue an invoice. Go to invoice. Invoices, create invoice. Now the customer, that is on November 6th, so change here to be November 6th. Now, 41 mountain bike tires. So the customer is Wembe Circles. Wembe Circles. Wembe Circles Mart. The item is mountain bike tires. Mountain bike tires. 40 of them. The cost is 500. Okay. Okay, so we can go to next. We can save this one. Save and close. Now we have the next one. That is 22nd November. It's also an invoice. 22nd November. And this one is mountain bikes, two of them. So the customer is West Border Circle. We don't have that customer, so we'll add new. This call West Border Circles. And the item is what? Mountain bikes. Mountain bikes. They are two. Now these are the cost of 29,000 each. So we change the rate, yeah? 29,000. It's going to multiply by the quantity. We can now save that one. Seven close. Now the next transaction is also an invoice. Ordinary bicycle tires. Another invoice. Ordinary bicycle tires. The quantity is 40. That the customer is Kuma Mwendo Tires at the cost of 230. So you need to change this one. 230. Now the date is on 26. Then you save and then you close. Okay. So we are done with that. Now the next one is credit purchases. Now in credit purchases, now remember the our company, which is what was the name of the company? Itanga Sacco, is acquiring goods on credit now from suppliers. So what we do, we just enter the bills, right? So we can proceed on credit purchases. So we enter bills, but we don't pay the bills. So we go to enter bills. Yeah, the supplier is Weiwei Sacco Manufacturers. Weiwei Sacco Manufacturers is here, and the item that we are purchasing, they are bicycle rims. So you go to items. When you look at this one, we don't have bicycle rims. So what we do, we add the bicycle rims. Bicycle rims. We just add bicycle rims. Bicycle rims. So in this case, I don't know the cost. We just been given the. So we know the cost because we are buying. That is 980. But I don't know the selling price. Okay. The other 75 sales. This one is on 16 November. 2016. So the quantity, they are 75. Indicator 75, sir. And the date is on 16th November. 16th. So you can now record the bill. 7 gloves. And the next one is 280 ordinary bicycles from Shanghai Circles. Shanghai Circles. Use enter pills. Shanghai. We had. Shanghai Circles. That is on November 19th. November 2016. So we are purchasing ordinary bicycles from Semgambane. Go to items, ordinary bicycles at the cost of 11,500. They are 280. So indicate 280. And you are purchasing at 11,500. Sir, 11,500. So, do you want to update? Don't update the cost. Now that is on November 19th. Indicate there is 19th. You can now save and close. Now the next one, they are mountain bikes. So from Rachu Sako. So here we are purchasing two items. We have a mountain bikes. Mountain bikes tires and ordinary bicycle tires. Ordinary bicycle tires. Now for mountain bikes, they are 146. At the cost of 350. Sir, 146 is the other one. 146 at the cost of 350. Now the other one, they are 220. At the cost of 175. So you see the quantity. They are 220 at the cost of 175. 175. Then we need to indicate the date. That is on 30th November. Okay. So you can now save the bill. Okay. So we are done with the credit purchases. Now I want to go to cash purchases. Now for cash purchases, we enter bills and then we pay those bills. Okay. So again, we enter bills, then we pay the bills. So the first transaction is nine mountain bikes. They are nine. Now let us look at the cost. motors or their mountain bike tires. Mountain bike tires at the cost of $350 each. Now, since I don't know the name of the supplier, let me just say supplier one, because I don't know the name of the supplier. Supplier one, and that is on 30th November. So that is on that yet. So on November 10th. November 10th, 2016. So 7. Okay, you need to indicate that it's November 10th, 2016. 7 and close. And because it is a cash purchase, I need to go and pay that bill. So go to pay bills. Supplier one, I select. And the payment method is cash, because these are cash purchases. So specify the payment method here. It is cash. Pay selected bills. You are done. Now the next one, that is on November 12th. 100 ordinary bicycle tires from Shanghai Circles. So the customer, sorry, the supplier, Shanghai Circles, and the item, ordinary bicycle tires. Ordinary, we got two items, sorry. Ordinary bicycle tires. Now they are 100. Now we need to look at the cost. 160. That is on date what? 12th November. Change the date here. 12th November. Then you save this bill. We need to go and pay that bill. But now the payment method is check. Shanghai Circle. Now which one is which? Let me just see the details of that bill. I go to enter bills, go to previous. Shanghai Circles, huh? It was 100 from Shanghai Circles. Now I'm not seeing that bill. Okay, this one. So I'm supposed to pay 16,000. So go to under pay bills, go to pay bills. This one here. So you check here. Then you say the payment method now is check. You select that bills. Okay. Done. So we are doing cash purchases. Now we go to cash sales. Now for cash sales, we are selling to the customers, but now on cash. That means the customers are paying instantly. So what we do, we create sales receipts, then we record deposits. So create sales receipts, yeah. The first transaction, ordinary bicycle tires. Item ordinary bicycle tires, they are 100 to 40 each. That is on date what? November 10th. Now, in this case, we don't have the customer, so we can just ignore the customer. Now, these are cash sales, so we specify the payment as well as cash. Then I can save. Now, let me say save and new, because I still have another transaction to enter. That is on November 17th. Mountain Pike tires, that is 146 Mountain tires. Mountain Pike tires, 146. Now the cost of 450. And the payment method is a check. Yes, I need to specify the date, that is 17th November. Nothing else. You can save and new. Now the next one, that is on 23 November. We have the first transaction there, Mountain Pikes, four Mountain Pikes. Four mountain bikes at the cost of 29,000 bet by check. Then we have 184 mountain bike tires. Mountain bike tires, 184. Now it is at the cost of 500. Also pay my mother this check, which is okay. Then we have ordinary bicycle tires, 220 ordinary bicycle tires. 220 at the cost of 250. And this one 250. The payment method is also check, so you need to look at the date, that is on November 23. Okay, save and close. Now the next one, this on November 29th, is 40 bicycle rims. Create a receipt, 40 bicycle rims. The quantity is 40. You need to specify the payment method. So no, the cost is 1250. You have been also given the customer name as Sukutsako Mat. Sukutsako Mat, you had. That is on 29 November. 29th. Now save and close. So we are done with that. Now the next transaction, these are now payments. Now for payments, you need to look at the kind of transaction that you are dealing with. So if the transaction involves a customer, then normally you go to receive payments here. If the transaction involves a supplier, that means we are paying bills to suppliers, you go to pay bills. Or if you are paying, if the company is paying salaries and all other expenses, we need to enter general channel entries. Okay, we use a double entry system. No, so the first transaction here under Binance is on 14 November. Kenya shilling 1,240,000 to Weiwei Sacco manufacturer. So when you look at Weiwei, let us see if Weiwei is a customer. In this case, Weiwei is a supplier. Weiwei. Yes, supplier. So we are paying. It means we are paying the supplier. So we go to pay bills. Then we look at Weiwei here. Then we need to see. Sorry. Weiwei we have twice. Weiwei manufacturers. So what we do, you look at we are paying 1,240,000. So you indicate here amount to pay 1,240,000. That means you are not paying the full amount of that debt. Okay, so you specify the payment method, that is by check, which is okay. Then you also look at the payment date. You are paying on 14th November 2016. And then you pay selected bills. Okay. So you are done. You go to the next one. Kenya shilling 185,000 to Raichu Sacco Tires per check. Again, you need to check Raichu if it is a customer. I'm not seeing Raju there. Go to suppliers and check. Yeah, Raju is a supplier. So you go to pay bills, select Raju. Now let us look at the amount that we are going to pay. 185,000 by check. So amount to pay. Yeah, you indicate 185,000, and then payment date. It is on payment date is on November 18th. Go to November 18th. November 18th. You specify the payment method. Payment method is by check. It's now okay. Please select that bills. Done. Now the next one is Kenya shilling 220,000 to Shanghai Sacco's by cash. Now let us look at if Shanghai Sacco is a supplier. Yeah, that is a supplier. So again we pay bills. Pay bills. Shanghai Sacco. Shanghai Sacco's, you are paying to 20,000. So amount to pay to 20,000. Select this one. Now it's Shanghai by cash, so the payment method here is by cash. Just I need to specify the payment date, that is on November 20th. Say pay selected bills. Done. Now the next one, these are salaries now. So here we need to enter general channel entries. So we have salaries and electricity. All of them are by cash. So you go to company, enter general channel entries. So we have salaries and electricity, and the date is on 28th November. So let me change the date. So do you have any salaries account? You had an expense account called salaries. So you need to select salaries and cash. So we need to debit expenses because expenses are increasing. So we debit expenses, then we credit cash. Debit 110,000 on expenses. Then you credit cash. Now we have the next, that is electricity, that 1,000. Create another expense account called electricity. Electricity. Then we select also cash account there. We debit that 1,000. Credit cash the same amount. Okay, so we can now save, save and close. Now the next one, these are the receipts. Now on 17 November, we are told receipts 50,000 from West Border Circles. So you need to check if West Border Circle is a customer or a supplier. So let me see, West Border Circle, West Border Circle, I think this one is a customer. Yes, customer. So you receive payments, receive payments from West Border Circle. Now the next one, we'll look at 58,000. So the payment method is check. Payment method, can you see now? Check. The date is on November 30th. It says save and close. I don't know what we are leaving. Sorry, amount to pay. Amount to pay 50,000. Then you know, okay. November 30th, 37,700 from Wembe Sacco Smart. So I think also we receive payments because Wembe Sacco is a customer. So that is the payment method for this one is by check. It's okay. Now we are paying, we are receiving 770,700. 770,700. And that is on November 30th. Seven close. Now let me check something here and receive payments. For West Border, the date should be 7th November. Let me change. Okay. So we are done. Now we are done with our transactions. The next thing is to generate reports. The first one is a trial balance as at 1st November 2016. So go to reports, account and taxes, then you go to trial balance. That is as at 1st November 2016. So as at 1st November 2016. Refresh. Sir, there's an error there. 2016. So this is the trial balance for that period. Now the next thing is the profit and loss statement for that month. Again, go to reports, company and financial. Then you go to profit and loss standard. It is for the that month. That is from November 1st, 2016, up to November 30th, 2016. This is refresh. So this is the profit and loss standard. So the company is making a loss of 682,920. That is a loss. The next one is balance sheet as at 30th November. So again, go to reports, account and taxes, sorry, company and financial. Then use this one, UK standard balance sheet. That is as at 30th. So 11/30/2016. Refresh. So that is balance sheet. So thank you so much for participating or for watching this tutorial. See you in the next tutorial.